My name is Pieter de Smet. I'm Professor Design for Experience at Delft University at the Faculty of Industrial Design Engineering. And I'm also co-founder of the Delft Institute of Positive Design. Positive design is design that has been created with the willful intention to have a long-lasting contribution to the well-being of the people who use the design. In our framework, there are three main ingredients of positive design. There is design for pleasure, design for personal significance, and the third is virtue. To start with the first is pleasure. That's very much in the moment. Am I enjoying what I am doing right now? Well, a good example would be a wine glass. A beautifully designed wine glass can be in itself a source of pleasure. When you look at it, it's a pleasurable experience. But at the same time, it also enables you to engage in an activity that is enjoyable, which is drinking a glass of wine with some friends. That enjoyment is also, in a way, part of the design. At least it is something that you can consider when you're designing. Component number two is design for personal significance. So you might be able to design something that is pleasurable and people might be enjoying themselves. But at some point they start to wonder, where does this all lead to? A nice example would be a drawing board, a product that facilitates a pleasurable activity, the activity of drawing. But someone who wants to become an artist or a designer, a drawing board enables them to train their drawing skills and then in that sense also to grow as a designer and to become a better designer. Component number three is design for virtue. So you can enjoy yourself, you can also have the sense that you're going somewhere, that you're making progress, but in all of those activities that you're enjoying and making you grow, you also interact with the world and you have an impact on the world. And that impact can be honorable or dishonorable. And this is where virtues come in. A nice example would be actually a design that one of our students made. She made a lunchbox, and in that lunchbox was a small compartment, and the idea is that she can put something in it to share. The virtue of generosity is actually designed into that lunchbox. Summarizing, positive design has three ingredients. It's design for pleasure, design for personal significance, and design for virtue. And what is interesting is that you, as a designer, should look beyond the product itself. And the beauty of positive design is if you engage in it, you're actually designing for human flourishing. And I hope that this little explanation helps you to become a positive designer. And of course, I wish you good luck with the competition.